Welcome everyone. In the last class, we have seen the different growth rates. That is, what is growth rate? How much of growth takes place per unit time? That is growth rate. And here, growth rate is x can be expressed. It is in that is arithmetic and geometric growth rate. We have arithmetic growth rate and geometric growth rate. In arithmetic growth rate, every time when a cell divides, it produces two progeny, okay, and out of that two progenies, one will be meristematic and one will be permanent. One will be meristematic, that is which has the ability to further divide, and one will lose the ability to divide and become permanent. So the growth rate is constant. At regular time, the growth rate is constant in arithmetic growth rate. Whereas in geometric growth rate, every time when a cell divides, in the starting, every time when a cell divides, both the progeny cells are meristematic. Both the progeny cells are meristematic. When these two again divide, they will again produce two meristematic cells. When those four divides, again they will produce meristematic cells. So here the growth rate is exponential in very high, very fast, very rapid in geometric growth rate. Whereas in arithmetic, it is constant and at regular time. Here, when we plot this, when we see this growth rate in the form of a graph, when we picture that is when we draw it in the form of a graph. So here on plotting, at one side we will be putting the height of the plant. For arithmetic growth rate, when we plot a graph, on one side that is here length of the plant, that is height of the plant, and on other side that is here we have taken time. Here on plotting length against time, in arithmetic type of growth, we get a linear curve. We get a linear curve. Here, this is, for example, this is the initial height. So, this is the time zero. At time zero, this was the initial height, because there will be some sort of height. It won't be just nil. So, here, at the starting initial, the height was this much. At zero time, the height was this much. There will be a little height. There is nothing which a little, that is there will be height. At zero time, this was the height. When it divided, it produced in 10 minutes. For example, if it took 10 minute time for the cell to divide, then in 10 minutes time it produced two cells. Then again more 10 minutes, so it gave four cells. It gave eight cells. But here one was meristematic and one was permanent. One was meristematic and one was permanent. Every time there was increase in cell. There was constant increase in cell. Two cells were produced and one was permanent and one was meristematic. So here the growth rate is constant. The growth rate is constant. At regular interval, the growth rate is constant. So we get a graph straight, that is linear. Every time it is increasing, constant increase is seen. The increase in the height is constant. So here, so this type of curve is called as linear curve. When we plot the size of the or the length of the plant against time, the growth is constant and at regular time. The growth is constant at regular time. So when we plot it in the form of a graph, we get a linear curve. We get a linear curve here. Now this is the equation which we get to calculate this arithmetic growth rate. We have this equation. Lt is equal to lo plus rt, where lt is the length of at time t, final time. The length lt is nothing but the how much of length, how much of has plant grown in a unit of time, that is the final length. LT is the final length, length at time T. It can be 1 hour, or it can be 1 month, or it can be 1 year. In 1 year or 1 month or 1 minute, how much increase has been there? The increase in the size is the LT, that is the final increase. LO is the initial size. LO is the initial length. Length at time zero. At the start, what was the length? LO is the initial length. At the starting, what was the length of the plant? That is LO. LT is the final length. After the time has been over, after growth has taken place, what is the size now? That is LT, final size. LO is the length at the time when we started this. And R is the growth. R is the growth, and T is the time. Growth rate, R is the growth rate, and T is the time. Here when we plotted, for example, this before, at the starting, at time zero, the length was LO, because LO is the initial length. When we started, the length was this. At time, for example, at time T. Now, after 10 months, after 10 months, the growth has increased from here till here. After 10 months, the plant has shown the growth, that is the height has been increased from here, from this initial height to this LT. This is the final height. So this is the increase in size per unit time. So how much it has been increased? For example, it has increased 10 feet. How much time was given? 10 months. In 10 months, it has increased 10 feet. 10 months was given. So here it was the initial length. Initial length was this one. Now at 10 months, after 10 months, when we have seen the size, instead of here, the size is till here. Instead of this one, the size is till here. There is increase in size. Every month the size was increased. So when we plot it, the rate is, that is the final length by time, how much it has shown, how much the length has been increased, how much the size has been increased in a particular time. So that will be your rate. In particular time, how much growth has been seen? Because here time was given, how much time was given? 10 months. And how much growth has been shown? 10 feet. In 10 months, how much growth has been shown? 10 feet. So here, if we count here, 10 months. So every month it has shown increase in 1 feet. Every month it has shown increase in, that is increase of 1 feet. So there is, because constant increase now, so every month, every time when it shows growth, it showed increase in 1 feet. 1 month, 1 feet. Second month, 2 feet. Third month, 3 feet. So like this, the continuous, because one is continuous, because when it gives one meristematic and one permanent, and that is constant and regular. So here, the curve which we get in arithmetic growth rate is linear curve, and the formula here is LT is equal to LO plus RT. When we plot this curve for calculating this geometric growth rate, so here at this one side we are taking size of the organ, and another here we have the time. Same here also, length was taken. Here also you take length only, and here time. In this geometric growth rate, here in arithmetic growth rate we got a linear curve, but in this growth rate, geometric growth rate, we get a S-shape curve. This S-shape curve is called as sigmoid curve. S-shape curve is called as the sigmoid curve. Here, this is the initial length. This is the initial size. When we were starting this one, it is the initial size. At first, the increase was slow. At first, the increase was slow. The growth was slow. Okay, increase, growth was slow. That slow phase is called as lag phase. Then, rapid increase in the number of cells has been taken place because large number of meristematic cells have been formed from 1 to 4, 4 to 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 8, like this large number of cells has been formed. So, there is exponential increase in the number of cells. Exponential increase in the number of cells. So, this one is called as, it was slow at the starting. Now, after slow for a certain time, then it has picked up the speed. Now, there is showing exponential increase in the growth. And after reaching a certain stage, it stops. After reaching a certain stage, it stops. Here it becomes stationary. The growth will stop. At first, the growth was quite slow in the starting. Then it picked up the speed. Then again, it stopped. The growth stopped. The starting phase, which was quite slow, that phase is called as lag phase. The phase where there was rapid increase in number of cells, that is the log phase, or we can call as exponential phase. And after some time the growth stopped, that is called as the stationary phase. Why this growth has been stopped? Why there was growth has been stopped? Here the nourishment also plays an important role. So, when the nourishment was there, proper nourishment was there, by taking the nourishment, the cells was continuously dividing, rapidly dividing. Then, when it divided continuously, the nourishment which was there has been used up by the cells, used up by the plants. Now, there is nutrition has been less. Nutrient has been finished because when they divided, now they have taken all the nutrition. Now, when there is no nutrition, the growth process has stopped. The growth process has stopped. It came to a stationary phase. The growth has been stopped now. Now, it will change into permanent tissues. So, this, when we plot a curve for geometric rate, we get a sigmoid curve. For arithmetic rate, we get a linear curve. There is constant increase here. First, it is little slow, then it picked up speed, then it became again stationary. So, it showed a S-shaped curve. So, to calculate this, we have the equation W1 is equal to W0ERT, where W1 is the final size. W1 is the final size after this, after 10 years or 1 year, whatever. So, how much size has been increased? That is W1. W0, that is initial size at the start. That is at the start, what was the size? R here shows the growth rate. R shows the growth rate. T is the time taken for the growth. How much of growth has been shown in a particular specific time? E, as it is exponential growth, then exponents will be where? For exponents, we should have a base. So, here this E is the base of the natural log. Here R, this growth rate is the relative growth in relation to something, in respect to something, in respect to something. Here, for example, I'm saying here is, I'll show you here. This is one boy, this is girl. if the girl moves here in this direction, if the girl moves in this direction, what we say? The girl is moving in the direction of the boy. The girl is moving in the direction of the boy. If the girl moves in this direction, what we say? The girl is moving away from the boy. Here, this we are using as reference. This we are using as reference in relation, in as respect. So this we are using as reference, in reference to this boy. If the girl is coming at this side, we say the girl is coming towards the boy. But with respect to this boy, if the girl is moving towards this side, we will say the girl is moving away from this boy. So here the important thing is in relative. We are using this as reference. We are using this as reference. So here also, in this also, initial, that is growth rate, is relative to initial number. Growth rate depends on the initial number. Here in this type of graph, the growth rate is relative to initial number. If the initial number is less, the growth rate will be, that is final growth rate will also be less. If the initial growth rate is more, if the initial number is 1, then the growth will also be 1. It will be, because final growth is in respect to initial growth. If the initial growth is 1, then the final growth will also be 1. Here, for example, if initial number is 1, then one more cell will be added. If initial number is 10, that is if 10 cells are dividing, so what will happen? 10 more cells will be added. 10 more cells will be added. Initial it was 10. When this 10 divided, it gave rise to this one 10, this one 10. So addition will be of 10 cells. Addition will be of 10 cells. If it is 500 cells, it will give 1000 cells. So this depends, this final product will depend on the initial product. So final product will be in relative to the initial product. If initial product is 500 cells, then the final product will be 1000 cells. If initial product is 1 crore, then the final product will be 200 crores. 100 crores, if it is 100 crores, that final product will be 200 crores. So the final growth will be in respect to initial growth. So that is why what we say, W1, that is the final growth, is dependent on initial growth. Initial growth. W1 is dependent on W0. In geometric growth, we are taking something as reference. What is that something? Initial growth is taken as reference. So how much will be the increase in the initial growth? So that will determine the final growth. If the initial growth is less, the final growth will also be less. If initial growth will be more, final growth will also be more. So this was about the arithmetic growth rate and geometric growth rate. In arithmetic growth rate, we get linear curve where at every regular interval there is constant increase. Whereas in geometric growth rate, we get a sigmoid curve, and at the starting there is lag phase, which is quite slow. Then we have exponential phase, which is very rapid and that is rapidly dividing. And then we have a stationary phase where at the end the cells will divide, stop dividing. And here in this, the important thing is the initial number. So here this final product will be dependent on the initial number, or final product is relative to initial number. In the next class, we will see, that is absolute growth and relative growth.